guys here today in my kitchen, and I've got great friends that are here from Louisiana that we've been planning this a long time. They've been wanting to share their version and their recipe of a seafood gumbo. They live in Louisiana, so it's as authentic as you can get it. But I've got a new camera person today, and I want to introduce you to David Lister.
Well, we're excited to be here, and all I can say is bonjour and laissez le bon temps rouler.
So this is Terry Lister.
Hello, everyone.
So this is her recipe. She was kind enough to share this with my viewers. So, Terry, I'm just so excited for you to do this.
Actually, yeah, this is kind of a tradition that we do. And down south, we normally do it like in the winter time because not too many people make gumbos during the summertime because it's too hot. But our seafood gumbo, we always start off, obviously, with the roux.
To show them the roux.
So we use 1 cup of oil and 1 cup of flour. And then you stir it till you get that color that you'd like. Some people like a lighter roux. We normally do a little darker roux for a darker gumbo. And you really need to turn your pot off, your fire off sooner, because as we all know, a black iron pot continues to keep cooking after it's turned off.
Tell them how you made that roux. I've taught them how to make a butter roux, but talk to them about the type of flour you use.
Really, it's just like an all-purpose flour. So it's 1 cup of flour to 1 cup of canola oil, vegetable oil. Do not use olive oil. It's just a canola oil or vegetable oil. And they both go in at the same time, and you just stir it. You really want your fire on a low to medium heat.
Okay.
If you go too high, then you end up probably burning your roux is what.
Continual, you have to stand over the burner and continually stirring, is correct, that correct?
Correct, okay. And it usually takes about, 30 minutes.
Okay,
but
perfect.
You're constantly stirring, yeah. So that's important.
So you all can see, David, can you get zoom in here so they can see that this is a dark brown. Okay, so we've got that going. So now tell me about this.
So what you normally do, and it's all on the amount of gumbo that you've wanting to fix, and so you start with your gumbo pot, a little bit more of water, so we have it boiling, so you really want to get your water hot and to a rolling
and
boil.
Is there any salt or any seasoning in this?
Not right.
Let's zoom in so they can see this pot.
It's just,
so you can get your big pot, you can make as little or as much as you want.
Exactly.
However, if you're going to take the time to make your roux, you're gonna wanna make, a good sized pot. And I just got done telling Terry, we're gonna put this in my canning jars and we're going to pass this out to anybody who's got a gumbo appetite. So Terry, what's next?
So next, once the water's boiling, you will, add your roux. Once the water's boiling with the roux for about an hour, mm-hmm. You want it to really dissolve. Our seafood gumbo is usually not as thick as our chicken and sausage or chicken and andouille. Oh, you got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it's really however you like your gumbo. We like our seafood gumbo a little bit lighter than our chicken and sausage. We just love our thick gumbos down south.
Yeah. So,
yeah, we want to make sure we get all that good roux.
Yeah.
Because it's time consuming to make a roux, so you really, and you can make a whole bunch. Like my mother makes, when she makes roux and she's going to take the time to make it, she'll make enough to where she can put in her refrigerator. Because you can refrigerate it and continue to keep, use the roux as needed.
Okay, so we've got the roux in the big pot.
And it's once it starts dissolving, you'll see your consistency if you keep adding roux to your preference. I can tell now that we'll need
more room.
So you have it?
Yeah. We actually, David made one this morning and I made one. Now normally, if you can buy store-bought rhubarb. Well, and see, for David and I's preference, we love to make our own rhubarb, especially for a seafood gumbo. I don't know why that we just always did that.
Well, you know how, so why not?
Right.
You know, it's not that difficult.
So this ends up being 2 cups of flour and 2 cups of oil. So this is the amount of rhubarb that we're putting in this.
Yum, looks delicious.
And we add the vegetables, which is, and it's all on your own preference there too, because I know Carol says that a lot on the cooking show. Some people like a lot of onion and bell pepper, and some, it's your preference. We use bell pepper, green bell pepper, and onion. Some put celery, but we just use onion and bell pepper in ours. Then you have your shrimp, oysters, raw oysters.
And we did a pound of oysters. Here, I got some roux on there.
Yeah,
pound of oysters. And we did about a pound and a half, maybe 2 pounds of crab.
And this is the claw meat. So you can do it with, we like the claw meat in our seafood gumbo. Some people prefer white lump crab meat.
I did my rice, and you guys all know how you can use whatever kind of rice that you want. I added a little bit of chicken base to my rice and steamed it. Then you're going to take a cup and add it to your bowl. So you can see I've got quite a bit of rice in here. Then what we're going to do is I'm going to take it over to Terry, and she'll scoop out the gumbo. We've added the shrimp, the oysters, the vegetables, all in the gumbo.
The roux and the water needs to come to a boil for, 45 minutes. Go ahead and add your vegetables, which is your onions, bell pepper, and if you want, garlic, celery, and...
So you can see all the shrimp, the oysters, the crab, the green peppers, the onions.
But the seafood is your last thing that you add.
Exactly.
Is that right?
Yes.
Then we're
seafood cooks fast. So
yeah, so your shrimp and your oysters, then you're gonna garnish with green onions. Terry says that you always serve it the Cajun way with a good French bread and potato salad. So I've given you guys all my Aunt Hilda's potato salad. And maybe Terry's got a potato salad recipe we can post.
Yeah.
So remember, I always post all this recipe, so this will be posted for you. Any questions that you have, make sure you reach out to me at Costello's_cooking. And remember guys, we're on YouTube now. So it's under Costello's_cooking. Terry, thank you so much.
Oh, you so will.
For doing this. I really appreciate it. And David, thank you for being my camera person. Thank you. It's a bow from David with the camera.
Bon appetit.
Thank you guys so much for joining my show. It's just so much fun to have Terry and David here. I'm so excited. You know what we do after every cooking show is we eat. So I can't wait to taste this yummy seafood gumbo.